Good morning, Quadcopter 101, and what I got for you today is another review of the Dragonfly Pro from Simtoo. Now, I did an initial review of this quadcopter using its watch controller, and there was a lot of notes from the peanut gallery, especially those who love the DJI, I'm sorry, folks, that's my Pittsburgh accent coming through there. But this quadcopter is also capable of being operated via its long-range controller. And its long-range controller gives it much more stable video, much more precise control. And that's what we're going to do today. And it also can fly it much further out. But with that in mind, you know, again, there is an option where you can get FPV from the camera, but that FPV range is only about 30 meters with a lot of lag. So primarily that FPV is for aiming the camera. But I want to do long-range flying. That's why we're here in Emos Canyon. I'm going to try to fly around the canyon a bit, get some video. I can go over that way, but I can't go over this way behind me because this is wilderness area off to the other side of me. So I can't fly off in that direction, though. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to go see Five Fingers, a local peak here that I climbed when I was a younger man. So hope you enjoy this flight, this quadcopter 101. Let's take it up. Well, my hat camera died on me. I just switched to a different camera. But in the meantime, I have started the camera already on the quadcopter. Then I started the quadcopter. Then I waited until I heard a series of three beeps to tell me the quadcopter has been initialized. At that point, I turned on the transmitter and the transmitter bound to the quadcopter. Then I waited another 5 to 10 seconds and heard another series of beeps, three beeps, telling me that the quadcopter's gimbal has been initialized and is ready to go. Now I have control of the quadcopter's gimbal via these two scroll buttons here. This turns the gimbal down, pitches it down, or pitches the gimbal up by turning counterclockwise. This pitches the gimbal left, or pitches the gimbal right by this right scroll wheel. Now I'm going to center that gimbal right a little bit right about there. Now let's go over the buttons real quick. This button here tells the quadcopter to take off, and holding the button down for 3 seconds tells the quadcopter to orbit its position wherever it's at. If the quadcopter is going up, down, or orbiting and you want it to stop, you can press this hover button and then it will just stop in midair. And if you hold down this button for 3 seconds, it turns the quadcopter's lights off. And this button here tells it to land wherever it's at by a quick press, or if you hold it down for 3 seconds, it will do a return to home. And right now I'm checking this number of satellites. We have 11 satellites, so we should be good to take off. And again, remember, I already started the camera and it's recording. And holding this down and to the right. So let's go to the air. We're recording. And right there, I'm going to let it hold its position. Let's see how well it's calibrated. And at the same time, this quadcopter calibrates via rotations around the up-down z-axis. So what you need to do, I recommend that you do, you don't need to do it, but I recommend you do it, do some of these rotations like this, these yaw rotations. That will calibrate your gyro. Okay, let me take a look at that gimbal. That gimbal looks good. Now we got quite a bit of wind here today, but let's go up a bit higher and forward. And what you're seeing in front of you right now is known as Five Fingers. Again, that's a hill that I climbed when I was a younger guy. Pretty neat though. Neat climb up there. It's very rocky. It's called Five Fingers because of the jutting rocks around it. But pretty neat. Okay, let's turn it to the left and pitch forward. Go up this way a bit. Pushing forward. There's a bit of a wind there. I'm not sure I got satellites. Because when I pitch forward, it pitches off in a different direction. Hold on. I think I need to calibrate my sticks. I'll have to do that in the future. So I'm turning, just rotating around the area. Let's see if it holds its position right there.
Well, it seems to be holding its position. Let's go up a bit higher. I hope you can see it up there. Now, that's its limit right now. I am in what's called normal mode. In normal mode, it only allows you to fly up to 50 meters height, which is that right now. And I'll rotate while we're up there at 50 meters. And it will only allow you to fly 300 meters radius from your position. Again, that's in normal mode. You can cancel that by switching to advanced mode, but I am not going to do that. I think that's a pretty nifty idea, being able to limit its range at 300 meters from your position. You know, it won't allow it to get away from you, in other words. And I'm just going to leave it like that, folks. I'm sorry. Maybe a future flight I'll try it in a different mode, but right now we are in normal mode. Let's bring it right overhead. And I'm going to point the gimbal directly down at me. So right now you should be able to see me. Hello up there. From way down here. So again, you got much greater control of the quadcopter by using this gimbal than you do with the little stick, or the little, wristwatch controller. So, okay, I'm going to take my glasses off so I can read my switches here. But right now we got 13 satellites. Well, we're good there. And we're going to turn it to the left. Oh, that was kind of a rapid turn. I wonder how that gimbal held that. And I'm going to bring it down a little bit lower too, folks. We're going to go forward and descend, making sure I stay outside of the Owens Peak Wilderness Area. Let me show you that wilderness area. This is, here, let me point it down a little bit too. But off to the left here is all wilderness area. And it hugs those mountains there and all the way up until the mountains, let me turn it around to the right, until you see the mountains off, and I'm gonna bring up the camera too, off in the right there. And straight in front of you, the snow-covered mountains are also wilderness area. And those are also mountains that that one there, straight in front of you right there, the highest peak. I've tried to climb it 5 different times. I've never made it up there, folks. I'm sorry. I was close. I was real close one time. But then my knees gave out. I guess I was too old at the time to be trying to climb that thing at that age. And I'm going to turn it around here. And bringing it back to my position. Whoa, it turns on a dime very rapidly. And coming down lower too. It's quite a bit of yaw turn to it. And bringing it down. And pointing it down toward me as I bring it down. I want to see how that gimbal works in holding it steady in a descent. Notice the camera strapped to my head today. The camera that I'm using instead of my Mobius is a SJ Cam, SJ6, that I recently got. My Mobius's batteries have been dying on it quite a bit. This battery, and I already replaced that battery. It's just getting old. So I wanted to try out a new camera, and this is the SJ6. Pretty neat camera from SJ Cam. I still got a lot of battery power, so I'm going out again. Go out over the bushes. Yeah, that turns on a dime, folks. So you gotta be real gentle with its yaw turn. I'm just doing it nice and slow. And already I've overshot. Again, I got a wind. There's a lot of wind coming up this canyon today, so that's another issue. Still pretty good for battery. Still half power. I seem to be getting longer flight time than I did on its first flight. So hopefully that gimbal is working out too today. The other day when I was flying it, the horizon didn't seem to be level at certain points. So, you know, hopefully the horizon's showing up much better this time. So, general flight around the area with slight breeze coming up the canyon. Got 15 satellites. Again, this uses GLONASS and GPS, both GPS and Russian GLONASS. The idea being an increased accuracy of the GPS system. Okay, I'm way over there. Taking a look at the rock formation on the side of Five Fingers Peak, also known as Akia Peak, folks. And let's try a return to home. I haven't done that with this box yet, so I'm going to hold down the land button and hold it down for a few seconds until it does return to home. That should be the return to home. That beep, beep, beep. It's coming back overhead. Let's see how accurate it was. Where did I take off from? Over here. Okay, it's overhead. It's positioned. It tells you beep, beep. Then it starts a descent. And again, if I want to stop it, I'm going to press this hover button right here to stop its descent. And dang, it's pretty dang accurate. Again, we got wind coming up the canyon. Let's see how accurate its landing is with the wind. See if it can land safely with the wind. And it can. Surprise. Again, remember, for it to be able to do that, I recommend when you take off that you do those yaw turns before venturing out. You know, that calibrates its compass and prevents you from doing one of these, toilet bowl effects on a landing. So, okay, I still got battery power, so we'll take to the air one more time. Let's see if I can arm it this way. Oh yeah, let's do a manual takeoff this time. Oh no, I did a manual takeoff the last time. Okay, we'll do a manual takeoff again. Let's do a land. Just a regular landing. Verify that it can safely land. Yeah, okay. Let's see if I can do an automatic takeoff. Okay, locked. I don't know why that's locked. We've got 14 satellites. Okay, maybe you got to arm it first and then you do the takeoff. There you go. That's what you got to do. You arm it first and then press the takeoff button, and it shoots itself up to about 2 to 3 meters. How's my battery? My battery's getting a little bit low, but we'll go out one more time. What was that? Beep, beep. Going out over that way there. Again, I flew this the other day and... Oh, low bat. We're going to bring it in now. I'm going to do a manual landing this time, folks. So lowering the camera down to see me. That beep, beep is telling you that the battery's low. When you hear that, you know it's low battery. Putting the camera back up and... At that position there, just lowering the stick. Now let's come forward a bit too, get away from that bush. And let's face it into the wind. The wind's coming from that direction there. And let's do an automatic landing. Wait. Let's see if it steadies itself. Again, we're over. Low bat, pressing the land button. And a nice landing. And we're home. Okay, before I turn off the camera, or before I turn off the quadcopter, I'm gonna stop that recording. That should do it. Recording is stopped. Let me verify that. Okay, yeah, recording has stopped, and then I'm going to turn off the quadcopter by pressing this button here. And holding it down until the quadcopter's off. So, that was the second flight of the Dragonfly Pro. It's a reasonable quadcopter. Hopefully the gimbal issue has been corrected here. I don't know what the issue was with my first flight. We'll see if the horizon looks stable in the background. But hopefully the video came out nice. So hope you enjoyed this flight. This is Quadcopter 101. Let me hold it up with five fingers in the background. Quadcopter 101, signing out.